RAF Topcliff lies in the heart of North Yorkshire, midway between the Dales and the North York Moors. The fast rural roads here are notorious for accidents.
I mean, it's on a fairly decent road here.
On the air desk, dispatcher Paul is monitoring the 999 calls coming in.
It's an RTC on the A19 at first.
There's a serious crash.
What I'll do is I'll probably set them off. It's sort of like round the corner from me, aren't they? So, head up, squadron scramble.
HeliMed 99 is airborne. On board are paramedics Al and Mikey.
We have been called for an RTC on the A19, literally at the back of the airfield. Don't have any details. Just been told that there's an elderly male trapped in a car that's rolled over. It will be quite beneficial to get there as quick as we've gone out. A 30-second transit.
The crash was caught on dashcam. The hatchback drifts across the road, forcing the van to swerve before overturning. It's not long before the team spot the wreckage from 500 feet up.
And there it is on its roof.
I reckon that'll be it.
Corner of that field then.
Passed over the big pylon. There's a car to the right, Al, if you see as well. There might be a patient over there.
OK. Clear down.
They're landing close to the van and a smashed car. The paramedics are prepared for serious casualties. HeliMed 99 has raced just a short distance from its base at RAF Topcliff to the scene of a head-on crash. The paramedics are expecting serious injuries.
The bloke in the high-vis has been in this vehicle,
yep,
that has landed as that. He's managed to get out. He's complaining of quite severe neck pain. He doesn't want to move it. He feels like he couldn't feel it when we first got here. Down there, we've got an elderly male who's been involved in the accident as well.
Al must assess the elderly car driver. Wreckage from the crash is strewn across the road.
Do you have any regular heartbeat normally, sir?
The 58-year-old van driver is lucky to be alive. He crawled out through a window, and Mikey wants to rule out serious injuries.
What's your name, sorry?
Terry Locking.
Terry. OK, Terry. Thank you.
I can't turn.
All right, no, that's fine.
If I try and move my head...
Don't do it, then.
It feels really stiff.
Right, round the side or round the back?
Round the side. Actually, it's the back that's holding it.
OK.
Van driver Terry is shocked and in pain.
Do you remember what happened?
I noticed the car on the other side of the road starting to veer on my side of the road.
Yeah.
So I tried to swerve left, hit me, and I was upside down.
Do you know how many times you rolled, or was it just once?
I don't know.
I think it was once. I got here, just kind of airborne.
Witnesses saw the crash happen.
It just clipped it, and it just sent it up in the air, and it was just literally flying past me onto its roof. Looking at the guy crawling out the van, you know, you wonder to yourself, is he doing that because he's all right, or is he doing it and he doesn't realise how bad the injury is? He's just, yeah, it's actually quite scary to see something like that and then see somebody come out of that wreck.
The elderly car driver narrowly missed an articulated lorry travelling in the opposite direction. Al's now checked him over.
This chap seems okay. He's not complaining of any pain. He's mobilised.
No, you just sit still.
Okay.
Don't move, yep. Don't turn your head. Nice, slow, deep breath. Good.
Mikey is concerned Terry may have sustained serious injuries in the impact. Local paramedics have arrived.
Hey, up, Jem.
You all right?
Yeah, not bad. He's moved, he's collided down all this side of his car and he's rolled once,
yeah,
he thinks.
Yeah.
He's got himself out and he's sat here. Now all he's complaining about is pain in his neck. I've not got there yet. He's holding himself still. He can't move. He don't want to move because it hurts. I've not assessed it yet. I'm just doing a primary survey, dude.
Do you want to start your assessment?
I'm just going to have a feel of your neck. Can you tell me where it's hurt?
His glasses are quite hurt
in there.
That's all right. It's all good.
Not particularly hurting, no.
Not
particularly hurting, no.
Herdes 9. Is there another ambulance on the way?
Al is facing a difficult decision. He wants to get both patients off to hospital by road, but local ambulances are at full stretch today, and only one is on scene.
Excuse me, it's just yourself and the ETA that's on site. Do you want a second vehicle responding of it?
Yeah, I would think so. I'll just check with Mikey that he doesn't think we need to fly the patient he's looking at, over.
This chap's, all his obs are fine, he's just 15, he's just got neck pain. They're just having a look at it now.
To be anything
he doesn't need to fly, but he's going to need to go to hospital. Whether we collar and board him is what we're just deciding on.
We might be able to discharge this old fella on scene.
All right.
I don't think he's really keen to go anywhere.
All right.
So I'll go and have a look at him, and if that's the case, that solves our ambulance problem.
Yeah, because I can go in this one.
C-spine is clear, it's a little bit lateral to the right-hand side there, wasn't
okay.
it?
To be honest, I can't believe I'm sitting here after that.
He's going to have to go to hospital anyway.
Let's just have a little conference. So, the old boy, unfortunately, is on River Oxaban, so he's going to have to go. Because I was hoping we could just... Because he didn't want to go, and I was hoping we could just clear him on scene, but his nose is bleeding. So he's banged his face, and he's on River Oxaban, yeah.
The elderly driver's on blood-thinning medication. He must be seen by a doctor.
You can't really tech two, can you?
Al's reluctant to fly either patient, taking the helicopter out of action for other genuinely serious cases.
I mean, does he need to go to hospital?
I just don't like the way he's holding himself.
He's sat there.
If he were fine, if he were moving about more, I'd be all right, but he's not. He's literally holding himself stiff, isn't he?
Shall we fly him to York, then?
Yeah.
Then, I'll get some good news.
Yeah, I was going to call you up. Allocated to the DCA, but showing 32.32 minutes.
Yeah, Roger, that's good. We were hoping that one of the patients wasn't going to have to travel, but unfortunately he's bumped his head and he's on River Oxaban, so he is going to have to go.
Another ambulance is on its way. This accident could have been much worse.
Oh, you're moving your neck a bit better. You nearly had helicopter flight then. We're nearly going to take you in helicopter. But there's an ambulance coming now, so we've got two ambulances. Ah, you can see us now. Hello. Right, well, we're going to get the stretcher down here, and then we'll sit you on that and we'll take you down to York.
Terry is beginning to realise he's had a very close shave.
Your wheelchair?
We don't have a wheelchair, that's the trouble.
Terry, take the ride.
I'm getting bloody fussy now, aren't
I? I know, so are you.
You know what's up, mate? I'm just bloody grateful.
I know. Could have been a lot worse, this, couldn't it?
Absolutely. When I crawled out that window and I walked, I thought, is this the end of it, or am I?
Yeah, you're very lucky.
You might get rest at week off if you're lucky.
What, is it Thursday?
Yeah.
Al is dispatching the elderly car driver straight to the nearest hospital, while Mikey gives Terry a last check over.
Anything at all? So you, as far as you're concerned, your neck's all right now?
Yeah. I mean, don't get me wrong, I haven't got full...
Why? What's stopping that, though?
I don't feel as though I want to do it.
OK. Yeah.
Well, that's probably a good reason not to, then, I think.
Yeah.
Both patients will soon be on their way to the nearest trauma unit, where they'll be x-rayed to determine the extent of their injuries.
He's been holding his head and not wanting to move.
OK.
He's got no C-spine tenderness, but he has got neck pain, sort of right side.
Right, thank you.
All the best, Terry.
Thanks very much.
No problem.
Thank you, Michelle.
See you later, mate. Take care. It's a fast road, is this? And it could have been a hell of a lot worse. There's thankfully not much damage to the front of it. He's clipped it and he's just rolled onto its roof. Lucky escape for both, I think.
Police have reopened the road, but will be investigating the cause of this crash.